Hi, my name is Emily Holman, and I'm the Communicable Disease Controller here in the city of Long Beach. There's been a lot of confusion, so I'm here to clear some things up. Today, we'll be talking about the difference between isolation, quarantine, and social distancing. The first thing I'll talk about is isolation. Isolation is a tool that public health officials use to keep sick people away from well people. What that means is, if someone is diagnosed with a communicable disease, public health officials will work with them to keep them in an area where they're not around other people while they're contagious. This is to help stop the spread of this contagious disease in our community. Quarantining is another tool that public health professionals use to separate people who may have been exposed to a contagious disease away from others in the event that they too become infected. Public health officials work with people who are quarantined to identify a place for them to be for a period of time. For COVID, it's about 14 days. And during that time, we limit their contact with others in case they do become contagious eventually. Quarantining does not mean that someone is infected with the disease, and it does not mean that they will become infected with the disease. It's something that we use out of an abundance of caution. The last thing we'll talk about is social distancing. Social distancing is a tool the public can use to avoid becoming ill. Social distancing involves avoiding large crowds and trying to stay at least 6 feet away from others. Some ways of practicing social distancing include visiting stores when they might not be their most crowded. Another option would be, instead of going to visit a restaurant during a busy time, you might have food delivered to your home instead. Finally, some employers are asking their employees to work from home or telecommute. That is a good way of practicing social distancing because it avoids contact with others.